Hi guys, Paige here from Hawk Optics. Today we're heading out into the field to look at how to zero your Hawk rifle scope. Besides mounting, this is the most important step in preparing to take your setup into the field. Once you have your scope properly aligned and mounted on your rifle, we first need to adjust the ocular focus. This focuses the reticle to match the characteristics of your eye. Start by getting behind your rifle. Look through your scope at a blank, evenly lit, bright area, like a wall or the open sky. Just be sure to never look at the sun with your rifle scope, as it may permanently damage your eyes. If the reticle is not sharply defined instantly, turn the eyepiece and quickly glance through the scope again. If the focus has improved but is still not perfect, continue turning until the reticle is sharp. We now need to access the turrets for zeroing. Some rifle scope turrets have caps, which will need removing to make adjustments. If your rifle scope has exposed turrets, simply pull them away from the scope to unlock. Pre-zeroing can be done either visually or with a bore sighter. This is a personal preference, but in this example, we are going to pre-zero visually. If you're using a bore sighter, you should follow the manufacturer's instructions. With your firearm in a steady rest position, open the action of the firearm and look along the bore to a predetermined target at approximately 50 yards. Adjust the parallax setting to the 50-yard position if you have a rifle scope with sight focus or an adjustable objective. Set the magnification setting to an appropriate level for the distance so you can clearly see your target and have a good view of the reticle. Adjust the windage and elevation turrets to position the center of the target, as seen through the bore, towards the center of the reticle. For the horizontal alignment, turn the windage adjustment turret clockwise to move the rifle's bore sight position left and counterclockwise to move the rifle's bore position right. In the same manner, adjust the vertical alignment by turning the elevation turret clockwise to lower the rifle's bore sight position down and counterclockwise to raise the rifle's bore sight position up. Note that Hawk rifle scopes have the reticle optically centered when new out of the box. If properly aligned with the bore, the scope should be zeroed within about one full revolution of windage and elevation adjustment. Anything more than this typically suggests a misalignment problem. In this case, try removing your mount and rifle scope and remounting from scratch before proceeding to the next step. Also, if using adjustable ring mounts, make any necessary major adjustment with them, allowing for minor adjustment using the rifle scope's turrets. In certain shooting situations, such as long-range bench rest shooting, when elevation adjustable rings are not available, the rings may have to be shimmed. We recommend using Hawk mount inserts, as these will prevent damage to the rifle scope tube. Only final precision adjustment should be made with the rifle scope's adjustment turrets. Now it's time to zero with live ammunition. Remember, all shooting should be carried out at an approved range or other safe area with ear and eye protection. If a bore sighter or any other bore obstructing device was used, it must be removed before zeroing with live ammunition to prevent serious damage to the rifle and possible injury to yourself or others nearby. Sighting in should be done at a distance that you're normally going to shoot, so adjust your parallax and magnification accordingly. From a steady rest position, fire an initial shot to see where it impacts the target. I recommend doing the following steps without moving your rifle or body's position from your initial shot, so you keep consistent throughout this process. So my initial shot was high and to the right, so I need to adjust my windage and elevation turrets down and to the left to bring my shot to center. Now fire a 3-round grouping at a target. Observe the points of impact and adjust the windage and elevation turrets as needed to correct aim. So for example, if the round has landed below where you aimed, then the point of impact needs to be raised. This is done by adjusting the elevation turret counterclockwise in the direction of up. With your scope zeroed, you can now reset your turrets to the zero position. Remember to push exposed turrets back into the locked position and replace any caps that were removed. If you have a scope with Hawk's zero lock and stop elevation turret, be sure to set your zero stop at this time. Let's head back to the studio. The more time you take in applying the fundamentals, the more precise your scope will be. Use this method to zero in your scope, and always remember to take your time, be safe, and always double check your zero before a hunt or match. Don't forget to like this video if you found it useful, and if you have any questions, drop them in the comments below. To keep up to date with everything Hawk, you can also check us out on Instagram and Facebook. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.